Okay, check it out. I'm trolling you guys. I'm trolling you. Watch. Does it look like the same day or a different day? Did I purposely change my spot and put a different shirt on to fool you? Or is this the same day and I am actually wearing these clothes for that day? I'm trolling you. Totally trolling you. Totally. You'll never get it. Okay, sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Some pretty sexy looking goggles. Go ahead, I'll give you 5 minutes to go take a cold shower, then come on back. On the same day, FXT Technologies sent me the FXT DVR, they also sent me that. That was my thumbnail. So, we're gonna take a look at these and see what kind of grade goggles they are and whether or not you could use them in some instance that would give you much pleasure and fun. Like eating a bowl of spaghetti and not using a spoon to wrap it up on, right? Because that's just challenging right there. I am currently not in the market for a new set of goggles because I love these little Frankenstein things I have that I put together myself and fixed because this was only antenna diversity and not a real diversity module and needed a little help. I had to put that rapid fire in there. And now with the addition of the FXT DVR, I'm pretty happy with this setup. I know, happiness. I do have to say, I do like these, but let me break it down for you before you think I flipped my lid and jumped to the dark side or something. I didn't. I just happen to like the shape and form. If you like box goggles, you might find this very sleek. Curvy, sexy. This is the FXT Viper. Even has a sexy name, Viper, like sexy, dangerous. Viper, that's a snake biting you. So what it is a very handy set of goggles that I think any beginner who doesn't want to break the bank on some fat sharks or some, you know, orcas or whatever goggles out there that is more than $169, because that's what these are, they probably like to have these if you like a box goggle. Now I'm not gonna totally lie to you. It takes a certain matter of expertise, class, distinguishments to wear a set of box goggles. That's why I wear them. You know, all those lowlifes wearing those stupid $500,000 fat sharks, ha 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 ha. They're not sophisticated, they're just lemmings. Me, sophisticated, because I wear box goggles. These box goggles come with the goggle itself. It has so much room for someone who wears glasses. This is not an official grandpa mode, this is just an example of how glasses go on in here. So I don't have to play the okay, fine, I'll play it.
Engaging grandpa mode.
As you can see, watch them go on, ready? Wham! Like a jellyfish sucking up your face, right? Wow! And I have my glasses on, so, oh, that hit me right in the head. Bam! So, this is also quite comfortable and adjusted. Also comes with a place to put your battery, which we'll talk about in a second. And there it is. Hotness before your face. Do you think I'm sexy and you like my goggles? Come on, baby, let me know. Suck it, Rod Stewart. In the case you get with the lovely, sexy Viper frames, you get a 5-inch monitor, which is diversity. I would suspect maybe the 5808 diversity, but it is diversity, has indicators for both antennas to tell you which is receiving when. That's the true sign of a diversity receiver, not antenna diversity, because antenna diversity can't tell that. When I originally got the transformers, it had antenna diversity. You can see no lights indicating anything because it's a lie. You sit on a throne of lies, Mr. Transformer Goggles. The lovely, lovely thing about these Viper goggles is they slip right in here, snap, and you can have this lovely view inside. Well, it's not on yet, but you can see inside, there it is, Looks lovely, doesn't it? How about we put some battery on it and see how it does? Oh, it looks like I'm gonna need another battery, huh? All right, well, for right now, plug that plug in and turn on that screen. You hit that button right there. One of the lights will come on, and it is on right now. We have a drone connected. This is the Joker. And if I could position that correctly, like you were ahead. Wait, let me see. You got a big fat head and it's hard to get it on. Just hold still for a second. All right, now I'm just gonna shove your face in there. So there you go. There is a picture looking through the goggles at the 5-inch screen, actually at the mirror reflecting the 5-inch screen. And you can see quite a lovely, lovely picture, isn't it? I know it's indoors. We're gonna test this weekend. Don't worry about it for now. Just enjoy the fan going around, feeling comfortable, and you're relaxing, and you're tired, you're sleepy. You will give me all your money. You will send me all your money. And you're waking up, won't remember anything except what I told you to do, and you'll do it very fast. There. All good now. Let's take a look inside the transformers. And you see a bit of a wider picture because that's 7-inch. That is a 7-inch screen, and that was the Viper had a 5-inch screen. So not too much a loss of real estate. Still as nice and lovely as the other ones. Looks like it's holding up pretty well against a Fat Shark monitor. The first thing I want to say is this going to replace my Frankenstein looking transformer thingamajig I made? No. It's only because I worked hard on those. The one thing I do want to say about this, they're very comfortable to wear, and I want you to notice something that the designers probably intended to do, and I was smart enough to notice it because sophisticated. When you control this, you use this joystick here to change menus, to pick channels, to take care of stuff. When you record, you go right up here. And there's the record button sitting right there. So very handy, hand-wise. If you wanted to two-finger it and be fancy like me, you could do that. Right? As far as the screen itself, I think it's very bright, if not just a tad bit over-sharpened. I don't see sharpening in the menu, which I'll show you a screen right here, screenshot of the menus. And you can see very nicely laid out, very clear. You can see everything. The navigation of the joystick is very easy and flips right along. There's plenty of instructions in the manual, which we'll go into in a second, on how to work everything. And the only thing that's disappointing is the DVR, because it does have a built-in DVR. Unfortunately, it's 640 by 480, just like a Fat Shark, which is really depressing. You know, why didn't they take their FXT DVR technology and put that in there? Because then you would at least have something better than a DVR from Fat Shark or any other module goggle makers that are out there. Now, let's just say you went out to get a FXT DVR and you thought, hey, I'll get those goggles too and use that on them. Guess what? You can! Because lo and behold, it is on. I can hit the button and you can see it starts recording. And now you can see what it looks like at 60 frames a second as a recorder instead of the built-in one on the monitors. While I'm recording stuff, the wires you've got with this is this, this one, and a power wire to a barrel connector so you can put a LiPo battery on. And as you can see, give me a second, I'm fixing something. The battery goes to a handy little pocket on the back, which I pointed out before. And if it catches fire, it'll just burn a bald spot in the back of your head. Me, I already got one of them, not gonna hurt me any. Don't say it, I already gave you one before, you lucked out, now you don't get another grandpa mode. Let's take a look inside the manual. And let's see what the particulars are. Screen size is 5-inch. It is a TFT LCD. I'm putting this right up here so you can read it, because I know you people like when I read to you, because I've got that sexy voice, right? I know. Resolution is 800 by 480. It is in 16:9 or it can do 16:9 and 4:3 switchable. That also affects your recording, so make sure you select the one you want. Brightness is 800 CDM. The video format can go auto, so it'll auto sense whether it is PAL or NTSC and switch for you. There is an HDMI AVI output. Max micro card is 32 megabits. So if you get that, make sure it's only, 32 gigabits. 32 gigabits. The antenna connectors are SMA. I have some ions on there temporarily because I like ions. They come with two whip antennas, but whip antennas are, you know, not the best. So it comes in this really, really nice case, nice storage case. For protection and stuff like that. I really like that about it. That was a very nice touch. This is a 40 channel receiver. And there are all the channels it gets. The DVR menu is kind of light as far as options. You can like format and you can delete and that's about it. There's no switching viewpoint settings or image sizes or anything like that. And that's really all there is to it. Because goggles. This is just an introduction to the goggles. We're gonna take this out along with the FX DVR this weekend and give them a little field test and see how that works, see how they go, see how they record. But for now, that's all you need to know about the FXT Viper goggles with built-in DVR and Diversity RX goggle, gigahertz diversity goggle, right? I don't need, do you want me to check and see what kind of underwear it has on? Okay, hang on. All right, I'm looking. Ah! It's got no underwear on! Once again, thank you to FXT Technologies for sending me all these lovely things to review. I appreciate it very much. If you would like to explore this further, there'll be plenty of links down below this video in the description bar. You follow that mad old monkey dance down there and start clicking to your heart's content. And then get back to me and tell me what you thought about that. I like to know. I like to hear your input. I don't want to be sitting here on an island all by myself talking to a soccer ball. If you know that reference, you're pretty good. Mighty Thor from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida. See ya.